Good morning, children. This is Venugopal sir. We completed B reading in the previous class of the fourth unit. Now, fourth unit, we are going to discuss the last reading, C reading, the computer game. The moment you hear this word, your faces get lighted up. Why lit up? Because you like computer games very much. This is a small lesson, a playlet, a small skit with some characters given there, characters' names. Gary Lopez, television game host. Joan Robinson, MT2, a computer. First noise maker, second noise maker. A boy and a girl from the audience. These are the characters there in this small skit. The scene is a television studio. Generally, these computer games are quiz programs you might have seen there on the television screens, being conducted in a television studio. So a scene takes place in the television studio. Gary Lopez, the television game host. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the computer game. Today, another human player gets a chance to match wits with our very own computer, MT2. MT2 blinks its lights and the studio audience claps loudly. So Gary Lopez, the television game host, means the anchor who is holding this television game, computer game, invites the audience there. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the computer game. Today, another human player gets a chance to match wits. What do you mean by to match wits? It's an idiom, which means to compete against. So today another human player gets a chance. For what? To match wits, to compete with our own very computer, our very own computer. What is the computer's name there? MT2. MT2 is a computer. MT2 blinks its lights and the studio audience claps loudly. The moment her name is announced there, MT2 starts blinking. And the audience who attended the game there in the studio, they started clapping loudly. Gary Lopez continues now. Today's player is Joan Robinson from the Oak Street School. Feeling smart, Joan? And he announces the player, the human player who is going to compete against or match wits with a computer MT2, that is none other than a boy named Joan Robinson from the Oak Street School. Are you feeling smart? Are you feeling ready, Joan? Are you feeling anxious or anxiety? Joan says, ready? Yes, I am ready. Gary Lopez, I hope so. I hope so, you are ready all. May I remind you, no one has beaten MT2 yet. Beaten means here what? Defeated. May I remind you, before we start the game, may I remind you, respected audience, that up to now, nobody has defeated MT2. Now, here is how we play the game. Now, he started telling the rules of the game, how we are going to play the game. I will ask a question. The first player to sound a noise maker and give the correct answer scores 1 point. There are two players. One is Joan Robinson, the other one is MT2, the computer. I will ask a question. Who is saying all these things? Gary Lopez is explaining the rules of the game. The first player to sound a noise maker, there are two noise, first noise maker, second noise maker. Once the first player, whoever, between the two players, whoever makes a noise with the noise maker, makes or sounds the noise maker, and who that person will be given the chance to answer the question first, and if he gives the correct answer, he will get 1 point. Means they will press the buzzer. Whichever player gives the buzzer first or sound first or sounds the noise maker first, he will be given the chance to answer first. If the answer is correct, he will get 1 point. The first player to earn 3 points wins the game. Whoever wins the first 3 points, whoever earns the first 3 points in the game will be the winner of the game. Ready, players? John says, ready. MT2 in a flat voice, I am prepared to play. So both players, one is a computer, other one is a human being, a boy by name John Robinson. Gary Lopez, first question, how much is 62,415 times 78,921? First noise maker, bleep. First noise maker is sounded there. MT2 starts answering. The correct answer is 4,925,854,215. Because it's a computer, it calculated this particular sum so quickly. How much is 62,415 times 78,921 means what? 62,415 into 78,921. If you are asked to do this sum, it will take some time, but in a computer, it takes hardly a few seconds. So computer answered it immediately. 4,925,854,215. Gary Lopez, right, 1 point for the computer. Gary Lopez announces, you are absolutely right, correct answer. 1 point for the computer. The audience claps politely. Next question, listen carefully. Second question, listen carefully. What date in history did the pilgrims land at Plymouth Rock? This is related to history. Listen to carefully, my dear players. What date in history did the pilgrims land at Plymouth Rock? Pilgrims are the people who visit holy places for the darshan of Lord. Second noise maker, now John Robinson, that boy, human competitor, buzz. John says, 1620. Gary Lopez, I'm sorry. That's not an exact enough answer. I'm sorry, your answer is not exact enough, correct. First noise maker, now the computer bleeps. MT2 says, the pilgrims landed at Plymouth Rock on December 21 of the year 1620. Whereas, John Robinson gave only the year, 1620, but it was not exact enough answer. The computer MT2 gave the exact answer like this, the pilgrims landed, means they kept their foot there, they set their foot there at Plymouth Rock on December 21 of the year 1620. Gary Lopez, right, 2 points for the computer because the computer answered the first two questions correctly. If MT2 answers the next question correctly, it's all over, John. Because already he announced there at the beginning itself, up to now nobody has defeated the MT2 computer. Now 2 points for the computer. If the computer is able to score one more point, the computer will win the game, John Robinson will lose. So he cautions John Robinson, if MT2 answers the next question correctly, it's all over for you, John. Boy in audience, come on, John. One boy in audience started encouraging. Come on, John, you can do it. Girl in the audience, you can beat the talking tin can. You can beat means you can defeat. Another girl in the audience, she is saying, you can defeat the talking tin can. What is the talking tin can here? MT2 computer. You can easily beat, you can easily defeat the talking tin can. Gary Lopez, quiet please. And here is the next question. Silence please. And Gary Lopez was about to ask the next question. Now John Robinson asks, wait. He asks Gary Lopez to wait. Gary Lopez, what's the matter? Why did you stop me? John, could someone else ask the question please? He asked the quiz master, Gary Lopez, the game host, computer game host, could someone else ask the question, please? Why are you asking all those questions, master? You please sit down, take rest, let somebody ask the question. Gary Lopez, what for? But Gary Lopez asked, what for? Why are you asking for another person to ask the question? John says, maybe I will have better luck with someone else. I am unlucky now in the first two questions. I will have or I may have better luck if somebody else asks the question. The girl in the audience says, coming up on stage, I will ask it, John. Immediately the girl in the audience, she got up onto the stage. And I will ask it, John. John's whispering to her. John starts talking. He starts whispering to that girl. Put it in the form of a command. I think the computer is only programmed for questions. So he gave her a hint. Hint. What is that hint there? Please put your question in the form of a command, because I understand, I think the computer is only programmed for questions. If you put the question in the form of a command, the computer cannot answer, then I can win. The girl asked, looking at a question, spell the word chrysanthemum. John Robinson only gave her the question there. Looking at the question, she asked the computer there, spell the word chrysanthemum. First noise maker, bleep. Means MT2 says, chrysanthemum is spelled, because it's in the form of a command, not in the form of a question. So the computer is not able to answer. Girl, yes. MT2, I do not follow the question. Please repeat in the programmed form. Immediately the computer says, I do not follow the question. I do not understand the question. Please repeat the question in the programmed form. What is the programmed form? It should be asked in the form of a question. Second noise maker immediately sounded the buzzer. Buzz. John starts giving the answer there. John Robinson. Chrysanthemum. Chrysanthemum. Girl. Right. 1 point for John. Girls. Starts shouting loudly, 1 point for John. Boy says, hurrah, boy in the audience. MT2 slowing down now. The computer is slowing down. I am MT2, computer. I am MT2. I am empty. Empty. M-T. Empty means what? Nothing. Gary Lopez, the computer is breaking down. Oh my God, the computer is breaking down. Means shutting down. Gary Lopez started shouting. Boy says, then John is the winner. When computer cannot play anything more, John should be declared the winner. The boy from the audience shouted. Suddenly, MT2's lights begin flashing wildly. The computer lights start flashing wildly, and then smoke pours out of its top. Smoke comes out of its top. What happened? The computer broke down completely. Gary Lopez, look what you have done. It has blown a fuse. That means computer has blown a fuse. That's why smoke started coming out of its top. Means it cannot work any further. See, my dear John, what you have done there. Look what you have done. It has blown a fuse because you have asked the question in the form of a command, that girl. John says, now that's what I call a poor loser. I call the computer a poor loser. Bad luck, my dear computer. So ultimately, this is written by Stephen Otfinowski. It's a funny game. Actually, a game to cheat the computer. It was kept in the form of a command, but the computer is programmed only for questions. So in the comprehension, there are some questions. You see, who was the quiz master? First question, Gary Lopez was the quiz master. Number two, who won the game at the end? John Robinson won the game at the end. The boy from the Oak Street School, John Robinson, won the game at the end. Question number three, how did the boy counter the computer? The boy countered the computer by asking the girl to put the question in the form of a command. Question number four. Why do you think the computer failed to answer the girl's question? Because it is only programmed for questions, whereas the girl's question was put in the form of a command. That's why she failed to answer. If question number five. If you were to ask a question, what question would you ask? Suppose you would like to ask a question to the in the computer game, what question would you like to ask the computer? It's your own answer there. There is no common answer for this. In the writing task, this is must, you must write there. It's writing. Imagine you owned a robot that could do anything you wanted. Suppose you have a robot and whatever you wanted, it will do. But suddenly there was a problem in it and it started doing something different from what you said. Suddenly that robot had got a problem in it and it started doing differently from what you have said. Create a funny situation and write the dialogue between you and the robot. So when you ask something, the computer does something else, that robot. So create a funny situation and start writing the dialogues between you and the robot in a funny way and present it before the class. Get ready to present it before the class, children. With that, we come to the end of C reading also. Thank you very much.